Now we will explain lecture 5 in electronics for English students. In previous lectures, we explained the basic circuit elements and explained that any electronic circuit should contain a voltage source, current source, and resistors. Then for circuit analysis techniques, we took electronic laws, which are KVL, KCL, voltage division, current division, and Ohm's law. Then we will explain nodal and mesh analysis. Lecture 5 contains nodal analysis method. Nodal analysis method is a straightforward method with specific steps that we apply on the given electronic circuit. To get or to calculate the value of unknown current or volt in the circuit. To understand the steps of nodal analysis, we will take this example. Nodal analysis contains three main steps to apply nodal analysis to this circuit. We have to get or apply three main steps. The first step is to define the reference node on the circuit. reference node is a point in the circuit. Is a point in the circuit that is connected to the negative of the input source. Okay. If you consider this source and this negative terminal, if you consider this this voltage source and this and that negative terminal, then the reference node will be this point, which is connected directly to the negative terminal. So this is a reference node. Also, we can consider this point as reference node since it is connected directly with it. And it is the same point. Then we can consider this point as a reference node and this node as a reference node. So for this given circuit, after applying the first step of nodal analysis, this point can be considered as reference node. Since these are four same points as that can be considered as reference node, you should point to only one node of this of these nodes, not all four nodes. if the circuit has many different many reference nodes, you can consider any one of them. Okay. For the second step in the nodal analysis method is to define the node voltages, is to define other nodes in the circuit other than the reference node. The second step in the node analysis is to define any node that is considered as any point that is considered as node other than the reference node. Okay, if we look at this circuit, we will find that this point can be considered as a node voltage. And this point can be considered as node voltage. This point, we can refer it to it as V1, and this is V2. This can be considered as a node voltage, since it connects between different branches, this branch, and this branch, and this branch. V2 can be considered as node voltage since it is a point in the circuit that connects between this branch, and this branch. Okay. The third step of the nodal analysis is to apply KCL to each node voltage. If we look at this node V1, we should apply KCL on this node. Okay. Then we apply the KCL rule on this node also. Okay. What if I apply the KCL in node V1? KCL states that the summation of current in a node equals the summation of current out of this node. How to know the current direction that is in entering a node and the current direction that is out of the node? Feel free to do assumption as you like. We can assume that the current entering to this node and current entering this node from this direction and this direction. Also, we can assume that the current is out of this node. We can do another assumption. يعني we have many. يعني you have to choose any assumption you prefer. We can assume that the current entering this node from this direction and this current is split to this current and this current. So the current in this direction is out of the node and the current in this direction is out of the node. V1. Okay. We need to write the KCL equation explicitly. After assuming that the current is entering this node in this direction and the current is out of this node in this direction. Okay. KCL equation will be summation of current entering, which is only one value, the current in this direction. The current will be V over R according to Ohm's law. Current in this direction will be V over R. 10 over 1. Okay, so the current in will be 10 over 1. This current value equals the current out, equals the current in this branch and the current in this branch. How to get the current in this branch and the current in this branch? Current in this branch equals V over R, V1 minus 0 over 5. And the current in this direction will be V1 minus V2 over 2 ohm. In this branch, so the equation will be 10 over 1 equals V1 minus 0 over 5 plus V1 minus V2 over 2. This will be the KCL equation for V1. While getting the current value in this this direction or in this branch, I say that V1 minus 0. This point has a node voltage 0 since it is a reference node, since it's connected directly to the negative terminal of the source. Okay, and in this direction, I mentioned that the current will be V1 minus V2 over V1 minus V2 over 2. For this branch, the current is 10 minus V1 over 1. 10 minus V1 over 1. The difference in voltages around the terminal over the resistance value. 10 This will be the equations after applying the KCL on node V1 will be 10 minus V1 over 1 the current in equals the current out equals this current and this current. This current is V1 minus V2 over 2, V1 minus 2, V2 over 2, plus V1 minus 0 over 5, V1 minus 0 over 5. V1 minus 0 since it is a reference root, okay? For the KCL, in this node, how to know the current entering this node and the current out of this node? We have to do the assumption, but we are limited to the assumption that we did in the other node. In other words, in this node, I make assumptions that the current is out of this node, which means that the current is entering this node. Okay, and in node V1, I make the assumption that the current is out of this node in this direction. So the current in V2 will be entering entering it from this direction, from the direction of 2-ohm resistor. Cool. Okay, for this branch, the current will be entering this node. So I have two entering current, current from 2-ohm resistor and the current from 2 ampere. Then we can do assumption that the current is out of this node in this direction. The current will be out in 10-ohm resistor. You can notice that in this direction, while getting the KCL or getting the current in this branch, I will substitute by the current value by 2 ampere, not V over R, since I have directly the current value. Okay, for this for applying the KCL on node V2, I will get this equation: current in equal current out. Current in V1 minus V2 over 2 plus 2 ampere current in equal V2 minus 0 over 10. V2 minus 0 over 10. Okay? This is the current for this node. Again, V1 minus V2 over 2 plus 2 equal V2 minus 0 over 10. We said that V2 minus zero, since this point is a reference node. In this equation, we didn't get the current by dividing the voltage over resistor, since I have the direct value of the current. Okay, the current in this branch is called 2 ampere. So I will add in the equation plus 2. Okay, this is for this example. So the main steps of a nodal analysis is to first choose the reference node, then define the number of node voltages. And the third step, we apply the KCL on each unknown node. After applying the KCL, we have to solve these node voltage equations. After getting this equation, equation one and equation two, equation one in terms of V1 and V2, equation two in terms of V1 and V2, we have to simplify this equation and then solve these two equations to get V1 and V2. This is another example about nodal analysis. To apply the three main steps of the reference of the nodal analysis in this circuit, for the reference node, the first step is to get the reference node. We can find that this point can be considered as reference node, and this point, and this point, and this point, and this point. All these points can be considered as reference node, but you shouldn't get all these points or refer to this point. You have to choose only one of them. Okay, say point, this point. Okay, this point or this point. For the second step is to get the node voltages. Is to search for any other point in the circuit that connect between two or more branches. I can find that node 1 and node 2 can be considered as node voltage. This one is called is called V1, since it connect between this branch and this branch and this branch and this branch. For node V2 can be considered as a node voltage, since it connects, since it is a point in the circuit that connects between this branch, and this branch, and this branch. Okay. For the third step, we apply the KCL for each for each node voltage. After applying in the KCL in this node, we do the summation of current in equals summation of current out. We can do assumption that the current is entering this node in this direction and is out of this node in this direction. The current of the direction of I3, the direction of J3, the direction of J1. Okay, so after to get the equation of KCL, I can get the equation I1 equal I3 plus V1 minus V2 multiplied by J3 plus V1 minus 0 multiplied by J1, assuming that J is the inverse of the resistor value. Again, to get the KCL equation on node V1, I am doing the assumption that the current is entering in this direction and the current is out of this direction, direction of I3, direction of J3, direction of J1. The KCL equation will be I1 equal I3 زائد أو plus V1 minus V2 multiplied by J3 plus V1 minus 0 multiplied by J1. Okay. Generally, we mention in the previous example that to get the current in this branch, we do V1 minus V2 over R3. This value is J3, and J3 is the inverse of the value of the resistor. So we didn't do the division, we do a multiplication. Okay? So we will get this equation at node 1. We will get I1 equal I3 plus V1 minus V2 multiplied by J3 plus V1 minus 0 multiplied by J1. Okay? For node 2, we can do any assumption, but we are limited to the assumption of the other node. In the other node, we do the assumption that the current is out of this in this direction, is out in this direction. These branches is current entering to node V2. We can add the current in this branch to be entering this to V2. Then the current in branch J2 will be out of this node. Okay. So the equation will be the summation of current in equal the current out. Current in are three branches and the current out is only one branch. The equation will be I3 plus V1 minus V2 multiplied by J3 plus plus I2 equal V2 minus 0 multiplied by J2. The current in I3 plus I2 plus V1 minus V2 multiplied by J3, V1 minus V2 multiplied by J3 equal the current out, which is V2 minus 0 multiplied by J2. V2 minus 0 multiplied by J2. This is for this example. For this example, after applying all the steps of nodal analysis, we can find that this point can be considered as node reference node. We can search for any other node that can be considered also as a reference node. We can find that, we can say that this point is can be considered as a reference node. And this point, since they are the same point, there is no component between them. This point is a reference node, and this point is a reference node, no component between them. This point can be considered as a reference node, and this point, and also this point, and this point. Okay? So all these red points can be considered as reference node. Again, you shouldn't define all these reference nodes. You have to define only one of them. Okay. Say this node is a reference node. Then after searching for node voltage in this circuit, we can find that this point is a node voltage and this point is a node voltage. We have V1 and V2 node voltages. V1 connect between this branch and this branch and this branch and also this branch. For V2 connects between this branch, this branch and this branch. Okay. After applying the KCL on each node, we can find that the KCL equation for V1, we can assume that the current entering this node and out in this direction and this direction. So the KCL equation will be 225 minus V1 over 3 equals, this is the current in, equals current out, which is V1 minus 0 over 100 plus V1 minus 0 over 25 plus V1 minus V2 over 10. Okay? This will be the equation after applying KCL on node 1. Node 1 will be 225 minus V1 over 3, the current in, equal summation of current out. Current out will be V1 minus 0 over 100, V1 minus 0 over 100, plus V1 minus 0 over 25, plus V1 minus V2 over 10. Okay? This is for KCL on node 1. For node V2, we apply the KCL, but we are limited to the assumption that we did in the previous step. So the current entering this node must be in this direction, but we can assume that the current is out in this direction and this direction. So we will find that current in V1 minus V2 over 10 equals V2 minus 0 over 60 plus V2 minus 0 over 30. Okay, the equation will be V1 minus V2 over 10, current in equal summation of current out. Current out V2 minus 0 over 60 plus V2 minus 0 over 30. This is for this example. Then we solve this equation, equation 1 and equation 2, to get the value of V1 and V2. We will find V1 equal 10 and V2 equal 20. Now we took three examples on nodal analysis. And I think we understand in deep the three main steps of nodal analysis and how to apply it to different circuits. There are some special cases in nodal analysis. One of them is the existence of a dependent source in the circuit. This dependent source can be a voltage source or current source. The special case is the existence of dependent source in the circuit. If we apply the three main steps of nodal analysis, we will find this node as a reference node. Node voltage, this point will be V1 and this node will be V2. After applying the KCL, as we know, we will find the equation in this node and another equation according to this node. But the main problem is that while getting the equation in this V node, we will find a third variable called I phi. Generally, we have one equation for V1 and one equation for V2. Two equations. Now we have two equations with two variables. We can easily solve them. But if we have I node or I phi in this example, and now we will have two equations with three variables. So we can solve these two equations. To solve this special case of nodal analysis, we should represent the I phi variable of the dependent source by by its value in terms of the other nodes v1 and v2. Okay, to solve the special case of nodal analysis, which is the existence of dependent source, this can be solved by replacing the i5 variable by its value in terms of the other variables in the equation, which is v1 and v2. Okay. First of all, to apply KCL in this node, we will find 20 minus v1 over 2 current n equal v1 minus v2 over 5 plus v1 minus 0 over 20. V1 minus 0 over 20. This is for equation. For node 1, we have equation in terms of v1 and v2, which has no problem till now. For node 2, to get the KCL equation, we will find v1 minus v2 over 5, current n, equal v2 minus 0 over 10, plus v2 minus 8 alpha over 2. We can do the assumption in this to be is the current in this direction. So v2 minus 8 i5 over 2. The problem in this equation is that I have three variables, v1, v2, and i alpha. I will remove i alpha and replace it with its value in terms of v1 and v2. The value of i alpha, as can be shown in this example, i alpha is the current in this branch, is the current of 5 resistor. The current will be V over R, which is V1 minus V2 over 5. So we can substitute I alpha by its value, which is V1 minus V2 over 5. Okay, so we solve this special case. Another special case is to have a dependent source, which is a current source. We will solve it using the same method. Is to get all node voltages and all equations that we can find. Then we substitute the variable I1 with its value in terms of V1 and V2. Okay. For this equation, the KCL for V1 will be 50 minus V1 over 6, 50 minus V1 over 6, plus the current 3I1, the current N, equal V1 minus V2 over 2 plus V1 minus 0 over 8. Okay, for this equation, I have equation for three variables, V1, I1, and V2. I have to get any other solution to replace the I1 by its value in terms of V1 and V2. As can be shown in this circuit, I1 is the current in this direction. The current pass through the resistor 6 ohm. So I can replace every I1 in this circuit by 50 minus V1 over 6. 50 minus V1 over 6. Okay? For node V2, the current, the KCL equation will be V1 minus V2 over 2 plus 5, the current N, equal V2 minus 0 over 4 plus 3I1. Okay, so I will replace I1 in this equation by 50 minus V1 over 6, and replace I1 in this equation by 50 minus V1 over 6. These two equations are changed to be in terms of V1 and V2. Only. Okay, this is for the nodal analysis and the special cases.